Good morning and welcome to Channel 48 on this Sunday morning. It's still very early, sun just came up, and yeah, I'm gonna upload this video a little bit later. I still have some other things to do, and then I'm gonna come back and edit the video. But this video is about BlackBerry OS GNU Linux. So what's up? Why are you creating BlackBerry? BlackBerry is dead, man. What are you saying? I didn't hear you. What? BlackBerry is dead. Ooh. BlackBerry is not dead. BlackBerry is creating software for medical institutes, for doctors, for all these machines that keep people alive. BlackBerry is not dead. BlackBerry is not dead. But why do you create a distro for BlackBerry? Who are you? Me. I'm Puck. You know, and about a month ago, I got to know Freddy, and Freddy is a seller on eBay. So I got in contact with him, and we started talking, and he came to my house, and he brought me some phones, and of course, these were phones that I could help him to fix. I could get them alive again. I told him this and this we must buy, and so, and then we can fix the phone, and then, yeah, you can sell it again. So me and him got a special, yeah, how can you say that, relation. Because I help him to fix his computer or things that need to be fixed. I help him. And instead of money, I ask for instance, an old phone that I don't have yet for my collection, you know, or this one, the Q5, even the Z10. These are all get from Freddy for helping him with whatever his problem was. And you know, he was a happy guy and he gave me this phone. I love this phone very much. I hate these things. I cannot type on them, you know, but this thing even has a little, you know, virtual keyboard. You won't find that in the Q5, you know, and in the Z10 you will have Android as well built in. This thing as well has Android built in. I have WhatsApp running on this phone. Let me see if I can show it. Is it off? Oh no, it's still on. This battery life is amazing after so many years. After so many years, this thing is still having amazing battery life. Look, here you're gonna recognize an icon. You recognize it. You see that there? The APK Pure icon. And the RXTX. I can run Android applications in this thing. But that's not the reason why I create a distribution for BlackBerry. That's not the reason. The reason is that all these BlackBerry devices that I have here in the house, when I bring them with me to the rehearsal room and I start playing in a 4x4 little place where there is a whole lot of noise, and I put this thing to record that noise, I come home and I hear music. I hear fantastic music that was recorded by this Q5 or even the Z10 or even the 98, 10 or 20, whatever this thing is, the slider I call it. You see that? And I was like, wow, BlackBerry did not just create a device to use the BlackBerry app so people could ping. No, they would as well let the user have something beautiful in return when he would register it. Meaning, you know, if a BlackBerry user goes to some party and you see him filming with this phone, or he's just recording with this phone with the built-in microphone, you know, he's gonna come home and have a way better recording than for instance the users that come there with their fantastic Galaxy Samsung S6 that will also film in the wrong way. I think everybody that films like that learned it from BlackBerry. These people were BlackBerry users before, because with the BlackBerry you can film like this and the thing will be a widescreen video. You don't have to hold it like this. So BlackBerry has some special some special, we zeggen in Dutch, we say karaktertrekjes, and that means personality. It has a special personality that I adore. I don't like it, I love it. So I'm very happy with these old phones that I got. So then I got the idea, I said, you know what? BlackBerry needs their own, at least, you know, that there is a registration of at least one person in the world, you know, just like Huawei, and just like Resurrection, and Lineage OS. These are all companies that I love from the heart. You know, every day I walk with, you know, when I go to the store, people see this logo, they don't know. But one day they know, then they go on the internet and they learn about Lineage OS. Say, I know this logo, oh, that guy is always walking with that shirt, with that logo. You know, I'm very proud to walk with these two logos, because this is my platform, and this is, you know, is my, these are my heroes. All of them, official and unofficial, all these guys that are creating works done based on Lineage OS, these are the guys that bring the runs to us, Android 10 for the S4, the S5, you know. So these things, guys, made me decide that I wanted BlackBerry to have their own operating system in GNU OS world, and that running on the Linux kernel. I wanted to have them there. And so this distro that I'm gonna show you, and that I released yesterday on my what was it called, on my Lindroid site on Facebook, those people, they got the first link. So if somebody already showed it here on online, this is one of the people. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna show you this distribution, but you must keep in mind that all the logos that I used that represent BlackBerry are from BlackBerry. That's why this distro, you will have to use it in a responsible way. You can keep it for yourself. You can give it to somebody that loves BlackBerry, that as well is a BlackBerry user, or maybe was a BlackBerry user in the past. What is the operating system? It's nothing more than Ubuntu 1904 that was built from the smallest ever file that exists to start creating a distro. And after installing only the server, you know, I then built it up, the complete thing. Cinnamon is the first desktop in this operating system. And of course, Ubuntu on Wayland is as well available, so tablet users can easy get around, you know. It's of course about the Cinnamon desktop. It's a beautiful desktop. I think it was by Linux Mint. These guys are heroes as well. So it's a mix, it's a remix of several tools and still a very special system, okay? You won't find a second one out there. You know, there's nobody, none of the BlackBerry fans ever thought, hey, you know what? We're gonna give BlackBerry something permanent, you know, and it, me pushing it here on my YouTube, you know, the effect it's gonna, because when you're gonna download it after 1 year from now, the thing will update itself. You know, if you're gonna come 5 years later, then of course this distribution will still work, but then it won't update anymore, because then this version is expired. You know, because this is a long-term supported a distro, and if not, I will just build a new one. Because Lineage OS and all these Resurrection, Huawei, you know, all these companies, I even have a YouTube OS, you know. So, but at that time, I didn't know if YouTube would, you know, really like it. Maybe I was like, maybe they don't like it, so let me not do it. So I removed it, but I still have the distro, YouTube OS. I still have that, you know. All the companies that I love, I want to give them their own OS, you know. So there is an operating system from that company out there, so people that love that company can go download that operating system. You don't have to trust me, trust Ubuntu. You know, this is done on a good platform. This is not I'm not the developer of everything that you see in this distribution. No, I'm the arranger. You know, you have musicians, they play the music, and then you have the guy in the studio, that's me, you know, that will put the sounds just, you know, in a way, and will arrange it this way, you know, that you, the listener, the downloader, will have amazing sound when you're gonna listen to it. When you put in your ear, your ear pops or all these things I call these days. You know, you're gonna hear something that you love. And that is what I'm doing. I'm arranging. You know, but I'm arranging and I'm only working with good musicians. The people that play the music there at the back for me. These are professionals. These are not guys that wanted to overrule the mother. No. You know, we can say, yeah, Ubuntu is not good, Ubuntu, but you all create distributions Ubuntu based. What kind of nonsense is that? Wow, we're talking 10 minutes already and I never showed you the OS. I talk so much. Let me show you what it is. OS is being used as a daily normal machine. I don't install virtually. I'm not a virtual guy. You know, I don't like these things. I like real things. So what I'm just gonna do, I'm gonna restart and then we're gonna boot from this USB stick where I, you know, restored the ISO file to. So let's just reboot. Yeah, restart. Restart anyway. Okay. Close without saving. Oh, let me turn on power. This thing is running from battery. Okay, now it's charging. Dun, you hear that? Dun. So, all right, are you ready to restart?
The desktop is logging off.
Did you hear that? That's Susan. That is how I called my voice. You know, Susan. And Susan is always there with us. You understand? So I'm gonna hit F9 so I can boot from the USB stick. No, F9. Just hit F9. There we go. And then we're gonna boot from the Lexar USB flash drive. Can you see that there? That is that little USB stick that you saw that contains the ISO file that we restored to it. Okay, so there we go. And all credits for me being able to do this goes to SystemBack, to Edmondo, to what is his name again? In fact, Franco. These are Italian guys and they are my biggest heroes if it comes up to this, what I can bring to you, because thanks to them, I can do this. There was another tool that I was using before, but it was creating way too big files and then sometimes they didn't want to boot. I understand a SystemBack and yeah, I'm very happy to have it and to as well share it with you and that the developers came back to bring life into it. So that's why, you know, I can do these things. Password for you will be channel 48. For me, it's already a different password because I installed it to the system. Oh no, of course, we're booting the we're booting the USB stick, so that password is just channel 48. The nice purple background that was of course powered by Ubuntu.
All systems initialized and started up. Hello, my name is Susan. I am your future assistant. Use BlackBerry OS in a responsible way. Have a great session.
Okay, so that what you heard just now at the end, that happened because I forgot to put the sounds on the right volume like this.
Welcome to BlackBerry GNU Linux OS. All systems initialized and started up. Hello, my name is Susan. I am your future assistant. Use BlackBerry OS in a responsible way. Have a great session.
So this is as well, again, a desktop that will greet you. All my desktops do. My Linux my GNU OS distros. I should really get off the word Linux, because Linux has only one thing to do with this operating system, and that is the kernel. And all on top, everything that you see is called GNU. And I just gonna empower the GNU organization, the Free Software Foundation, by not calling it Linux. You know, it's stupid to talk about the kernel that while, you know, you ignore the OS. would be stupid if we would call Microsoft by the kernel name, you know, and ignore Windows 10. Everybody's calling that they're Windows 10, you know, so why would you, you know, call the thing by the kernel? That is not, that is almost as if you're gonna call a human being by, by the name of one of the components of his body, you know? We're gonna call a human being a heart, yeah? Because that is, or maybe brain. Hey, brain, how are you doing? Brain. Is that not stupid? So all you out there that are calling GNU OS Linux still, you are stupid. Stop it, you know? I unsubscribe Brian Lunduk because he irritates me all the time with his nonsense called Linux, Pimp Linux, whatever he's called, Poco Linux. Yo, you guys, you should learn how to call the operating system, you know? And when you tell the guy, he don't answer you, and then some of his monkeys start jumping on your back, you know, these toe lickers from him, and you get jumping on, you know, I immediately unsubscribed. You know, then I don't get these stupid messages anymore. Brian Lunduk just updated the video. And when you talk to the guy, he never answers you. And he just has some subscribers more than me. You know, there was a time that I had more subscribers than him. And look at how he's doing. You know, he's not even answering me. You know, he's treating me like a piece of, you know, nothing. So then I'm like, okay, if that is your, you know, I don't want to have anything to do with you and your Brian Lunduk friends, because these are as well idiots when I look at them, you know, and the way they treat a stranger that comes or that for the first time types, you know. So that's why, guys, on my channel you never have to be scared to type, because I will always answer you. And somebody, one of my subscribers, talk bad to you, I kick that person out of my group. Because here on my channel everybody's getting answered and everybody, you know, is being treated as a human being. We are not sitting on high horses, such as certain channel holders. You know, you guys, you can all lick my feet. Because you guys, really, you have no respect for your subscribers. You think that you are some god. Because if you cannot answer somebody that is equal to you, then the effect, you are a loser. If you think that you are more than that person, you are just a bloody loser. Arrogant human, that effect, you don't even deserve to be here. Remember that next time when somebody talks to you. And this goes for every YouTuber out there. So this is the operating system, guys. It's beautiful again, as you can see. Icon pack is with compliments to Chameleon, the same the same ones that I use in Huawei OS. So in fact, these guys are my heroes as well. They are my family, and it's my blood. So they are with me, okay? I'm with them, let's say it this way. We have the Snap Store as only distribution in the world. This thing only comes with the Snap Store and not with the Ubuntu Store. So if you're looking for the Ubuntu Store, you will not find it in here. We have a Snap Store that will as well give you great applications such as FUBAR 2000 and all these things that you normally don't find in the normal Ubuntu Store, but in the Snap Store, you're gonna find it, okay? At this point, I'm not connected to the internet, I think. Let's see. I just pushed in the cable. Let me show you about the browser. I as well worked on the browser. And I messed up. I had to let BlackBerry page that had to start as the first. But I forgot. So forgive me for that, you know. Maybe you can edit yourself. Let me show you how to do that. Preferences. You go home. Go in front of the DuckDuckGo. And then you type blackberry.com space. And then you need this key. You see? The one with this. With a vertical stripe. Okay. Then you push down the shift and then hit it. And then one time space again. and then we're gonna close the browser, and then we open it again, and then BlackBerry should open as the first. Okie doke. So there you go. And this is official how it should start. Of course, the first tab that you will find is the bus to my channel, where you can always reach me. And I'm a guy, you can always talk to me, okay? I will always answer you. I'm not sitting on a high horse. So the second bus trip that you can make straight from out your browser is to find all American news, worldwide, Discovery Channel, Disney Channel. This is all live, you know, way too much to watch in one time. For my German people, these are my loyal users and my friends and my family. I love them very much, just like the American people and the Canadians and the Australians and the Brazilians and the Indians and wherever you come from, you know, as long you come to channel 48, you are my brother or my sister. So yeah, here we're gonna go to here we can watch live TV immediately out of the box, so you can watch the news. If you're in Germany, this all will play. If you're not in Germany, this will occasionally set to you're gonna see something like rightlich, that means rights, you know, copyrights, then this will not play for you. But hey, no problem, you can go here and find all sorts of series and all sorts of stuff, news, other things, you know, until that program is finished. And then, you know, the live will work again. And then you can watch live TV again. But as well, for my Chinese people, I wanted to have, you know, their country as well, at least their country. Here you can find TV to all countries in the world that have internet and that as well are active in broadcasting TV from their country, you know. So you can find China, Hong Kong TV as well in here. So this is effect for the world to find whatever they want to look at. And of course I cannot forget my own Dutch people, my Nederlandse mensen. They can watch thanks to NPO, you know, thanks to NOS. They can watch without having to install some DRM plugin or some crazy thing. You know, they only follow you a bit around whenever you just saw the permissions that I had to give to enter this site. But here you can watch the news, latest news from the Netherlands, you know, and that's just how it is. So yeah, you can add even more if you wish. There is space, it's very easy. Just grab a link and just put it there. Boom, you see that? And it's in your toolbar. So the same thing you should do with my channel. When you are on my channel, although it's already put it in there, you already took, that is already covered channel 48. Okay, here in the browser, thanks to Haipan, we also have a talking browser, yeah? And that means if we would go to the news, I think I already showed this in previous builds. If you go to, for instance, the news and you just want to know about the headlines, mine is in Dutch. Okay, so it will read Dutch to me.
Artikelkoppen: eigenaren juwelierzaak Waalwijk mishandeld bij gewelddadige overval. Bij een overval op een juwelierzaak in Waalwijk zijn de twee eigenaren mishandeld en vastgebonden. Tevens is er een schot gelost, meldt de politie zondag.
Zo.
Schot gelost bij overval juwelier, eigenaren mishandeld en vastgebonden.
Heftig.
Bij de overval zaterdagavond.
Okay, stop it. Otherwise I'm gonna go listen the whole thing. That's not, this is not the listening party. Your browser can now as well talk to you. Voices are powered by nobody else than Google Translate. So all credits for the voices that you hear goes to Google, and nobody else than Google. The developing was done by Haipan from China. So credits to Haipan. And I really love this application. It will always be in my browser. A next application in your browser will be the radio, the little blue radio that you see there on top. And it will let you play music from all over the world. This is Cuba.
Mogen we even voorstellen?
Nee.
Mogen we even...
Nee. Habana Radio. Classical, you know. Hey, I'm not going to demonstrate that. You got the message. So here you can listen to the radio while you're browsing. Up here we have, what is this? Oh yeah, here you can, with this thing, you can download videos from websites. Right mouse click on the video and just save the video as MP4. You know, very easy the way it should be. So that is all covered in your browser. You have very powerful browser that is, of course, powered by Firefox and nobody else than Firefox. Amazing, lovely, great browser. The best, I think, together with Chrome. These are the two best browsers in the world. Okay? Yeah. You have built-in Audacity. That is to record music. It can be music that you're playing on your computer. It can be music that you're going to connect via the line in to your computer to make a hard disk recording of the music. That all you can do with Audacity. Brasero will help you to burn a DVD or a CD. OBS will help you to broadcast to your YouTube or Twitter or anywhere you want to, you know, that has this service available where you have a key from. You can then, you know, upload broadcast straight to that website. We have OpenShot Video Editor as well, a very nice one. This is, you can say, the Windows Movie Maker of GNU. And here you will find a nice, lovely styled, skin where you can import video and where you can, you know, can as well make these things a little bit bigger. Let me see how that must be done. Anyway, here you can import tracks, you see that? And if you have a nice big screen, that would be really amazing. So we'll let you work very easy and you can export in all sorts of crazy formats. Even 4K is in here, you know, and this is something that every distribution should come with. And that's a video editor. That's exactly how it was way back in Windows XP time. You know, I think XP was in fact trying to cover it all for the user. And now nothing more is being covered. You get a bunch of apps in your Windows. A whole lot of, yeah, let me not talk about Windows. Please, Puck, don't. You cannot talk about Windows anymore. You are now as well creating operating systems. So you must have respect for your, you know, for your competitors, for the others. You cannot talk bad about them. So I will never talk bad about Windows. These are as well my friends. I love them. I have two Windows 7 systems still, but unfortunately, I will never ever update to Windows 10 because yeah, it's not my thing. It irritates me. It gives me high blood pressure, and you know, sometimes I just want to grab my laptop and throw it, you know, straight over my balcony. But I don't do these kinds of things anymore. Now I create my own operating system and I make it exactly the way I wish, you know, and you know, after that I'm being satisfied, you know, testing it for several weeks. I can now as well, thanks to the gods out there that give me that power, you know, create a distribution that noobs like you out there and me, I'm still a noob, you know, that we can, you know, do that and that we can share it, that I can make something for you and help you to grow with me, you know, to not be such a big noob anymore. And then at a certain moment you start understanding the terminal screen and you just love the operating system, even though once in a while it something could not run the way it should, you know. For instance, here I have that's Korean. This is samba, Brazil. This is reggae. China, J-pop. African hip-hop. This is for my African people. I have many African friends. They always come to my parties when I, you know. So, yeah, I also have Chinese friends. And I have Korean friends. And trust me, I love Asian people. Really, I do. This is classic. I love all people. All nice people. Did you see that? Under that classic, there is oh, let's go back, let's go back. Under that classic, there is a station. I think it was... Was it this one?
Wil jij thuis het snelst...
Indian? Couldn't play. It was above the classical. Where is it? Oh, it was this one. Okay, we're gonna remove this one. Although this is the live build, it will come back when we... Salsa. So you will just find a station that plays for you, Christian. Russian. I also love my Russian people, you know. My Russian smart people out there. My reggaeton people, you know how it goes. Spanish, soul, and international 70s. Russian again. I love Russian music. In fact, I love all music. I have no... This sounds like Russian Bollywood. Lovely, lovely. This one cannot play, so this one you can then right mouse click remove. You know, if something don't play, don't... Well, you can as well leave it and try it tomorrow, because these are probably stations that, yeah, only play at certain hours. So you don't have to start removing everything. Just try it the next time. But most of them... This is Indian. New World. So yeah, I'm not gonna show this complete list, but yeah, you understand. So yeah, Rhythm Box is, yeah, I'm updating Rhythm Box with nice streams, you know. And the streams, if you got a stream as well and you want to insert it and it plays, you must make sure that you put the stream into System X that you will find in your home folder. Oh no, wait a minute. No, sorry about that. You're gonna find radio stations. Where are they? Here, Rhythm Box add-on stations. And just pop your link in here and make sure you pop it into the radio. Then, you know, the next time it will search for that. If you're gonna remove this folder, then all your radio stations will be gone. Okay? Remember that. So don't mess up. Don't touch that folder. Only add a new link to it if you want to add a station. Yeah, so this is BlackBerry OS, guys. How to install it? Simple. Go to System Back. I have videos showing you how to install my distros. Just go to System Back, open it, put in your password channel 48, and then you go here to System Install. Hit that one. Yeah, BB. BB, and then you go next, and then you're gonna look for your drive. This could be any FAT drive or anything. You don't need GPART to at all. You know, let's say you're gonna install this as the first and only operating system on this system. You know, you're gonna clean the complete thing. Then you're just gonna go to your hard drive and start deleting until you have one drive left. Yeah, and then you can create a new drive, and then you can even select the space that you want to be left over with, so you can create a swap file. But hey, if you don't know how to do it in here, you can also prepare your drive, your drives in GParted, because GParted is in GParted. Where is GParted? What? GParted. You did not install GParted POC. Oh my goodness, peeps. I forgot to install GParted. Oh my boy. So what you then will have to do is just open the terminal, and then you type sudo apt get install GParted. And the password will be channel 48. You can install temporary unable to lock. That means another application is open that is using the SU, the administrator rights. So try it again, sudo apt get install GParted. And there you go, it's gonna be installed. This is a tool that belongs to this operating system, but it's not in it. You must edit yourself. And here it is, channel 48. Oh my goodness, this video is too long again. I wanted to make a short video. Oh no, 26 minutes, 30 minutes again. Guys, we're gonna close this video. But here you can see how the drive was set. Yeah, this drive is a little bit hard to understand, but the first is X4. On here I have a Linux partition. On here I have a FAT32 partition that is to save stuff and so, and that is as well compatible with other operating systems, so it's FAT32. And here I have, this is the SDA2 extended 7.8 gigabyte, that's a USB stick. Yeah, so yeah. Anyway, so that is it. A lovely operating system. BlackBerry OS has nothing to do with this. But even though they have nothing to do with this, because I use their logos, this belongs to BlackBerry. Okay? So you cannot go do crazy things with it. You cannot go and sell it. Because, you know, then BlackBerry is going to come after you. And me, myself, as well. So this is only for the BlackBerry lovers. It's a gift to BlackBerry because they created such beautiful devices. You know, when you're gonna connect your phone to the thingy, then you're gonna see a BlackBerry phone will come out here, one like this, you know, one like this. You're gonna see here small one, and then it will say, would you like to connect your phone? So that is all that is to it, my friends. Just create a bootable USB stick. You can do that in your previous Ubuntu. In here you can as well create bootable USB stick. Just type USB and there you will have the startup disk creator. And yeah, only thing for you to do is to go to other and then go to your downloads where you have my ISO that you just downloaded, and then boom, you know, select it and your USB stick. You need to select here. Don't, make sure you don't select your internal drive. You know, just go for your SB Live here and then make startup disk, and then you can boot it on any 64-bit system out there. This is 64-bit. Let me show you the specs. System, where is it? Info here. And here you're gonna see what it is, guys. This is powered by Mama Ubuntu. You see that 1904 Disco Dingo Team 64-bit Cinnamon version 4.09. Yeah, the Linux kernel is Linux kernel 5.0.0.3.2. All credits for that goes to Mr. Linux Truffles. Yeah, he's the father from the kernel. And yeah, thanks to him and his organization, we are now at, you know, kernel 5. Version 5, it's not so much different than kernel 4, he said, it's just a number. And this is all being done on an Intel Core i5-3210M CPU at 2.5 gigahertz, 2x. I have 8 gigabytes of memory, okay? And the hard drives, yeah, that is not important because, in fact, I'm running it from, oops, where is it, from this hard drive. You see that? That is connected via USB to this machine. So in fact, I can grab that hard drive and put it, stick it in any 64-bit machine, and then, you know, you will not get blue screen of that, just like in Windows. Sorry for that, Windows, I had to say it. But you're gonna get a system that will correct the drivers that it's dealing with, and it will boot up straight into the desktop if you're lucky. And if not, then I'm very terribly sorry. That was it. Back to the studio. Well, that was it, my friends. A way too long video again, as usual. And yeah, there is nothing I can do about it. I just talk too much and I want to show too much. And that's just channel 48. If you don't like it, my friend, unsubscribe. Have a nice day. But I know many of you like it, so you're welcome to stay. And at least when you're gonna ask me something here on this channel, you know, it doesn't matter if I have 30,000 subscribers, 100,000 subscribers, or 1 million subscribers, I will always do my best to answer you as soon as I'm in the position to answer you. Okay? So thanks again for joining Channel 48. Love you all. Really, I mean it. I love all my good subscribers that, you know, leave some love behind as well. You know, here it's eye for eye, tooth for tooth. You share love, you get love. You don't share love, you don't get nada. So that's it. Add me to your favorites. Hit the bell and, you know, all updates. But best thing is just to visit my channel on daily basis. Talk to me. I will answer you. And then, you know, you will not forget about your friend, Channel 48. From the Netherlands. I want to thank each and everybody worldwide for watching this video. Link will be in the description. Leave this video some likes, you know. I don't want to ask for likes every time. It looks really stupid. You know, if you're a subscriber here on my channel and you like whatever I do and you like me as a human, you know, leave a like behind. Otherwise, you know, they probably, you need to unsubscribe, right? That's just how it is. If you don't like me or you don't like my channel, then just unsubscribe. Go to another channel. There are many good YouTubers out there. You know, of course, they are not like me, but, you know, they will probably never answer you when you ask them something. So you must know what you have here on Channel 48 and what I'm giving to you. Okay? Salute. Big up to our queen of YouTube, Susan Wojcicki. Thank you for everything that you did. And I say, signing out. Have a nice day. Peace out.